guys, welcome back to my channel. It is such a pleasure seeing you come back to visit your girl. So I want to tell you guys, like, get into her. So guys, I'm definitely want to debut this new wig that I've been trying on. So I've had this wig for about a month now, and I tried it on, and I'm going to insert some comments that I've gotten about the wig. So this wig is amazing. If you look at it, it is a natural wig. It is made by Soul Tresses. It is 100% human hair, so it means that I can wash it, I can flat iron it, I can also create a couple of looks with it. But this is how the wig looks when it is uninstalled, and it has like curly patterns along the top. Pretty cool wig. So guys, this is how the wig looks when it's uninstalled. What's going on, it's like wet and wavy. So it has some little bit of curls, not too much curls, not too full. I kind of like my wigs to be like soft, not only soft, but I don't like really tight curls. I definitely like loose fitting curls. So this particular look is it's like a short little curly wig. Two things I like to use for my wigs is this one detangler comb that is good for natural hair. And if you can look at the ridges, you can see that one is to help detangle, and then the other one is if you like to do a comb. And then the other thing I like is this little dimming brush. I got lint in it because I just got it out my dresser. But these are the two must-have items for my wigs. And so what I also like to do with them is two products. My must-have products is my Wet n Wavy. I use my Wet n Wavy on this particular wig. Any of my human hair wigs, definitely like the Wet n Wavy product, and then the Cantu just for oils. So if I look, you know, like if my wig is looking like it needs to be oiled, it's looking a little bit rather dry, I like to go in it with some oil sheen. Not too much, just enough to get the job done. And then I do a little bit of the Wet n Wavy. And so what I do then is like comb it out like how I want it to look. So if I want it to just have like a lot of, not really a lot of curls, but just a little bit of bump, I'll do it like this and just kind of run my hair through this one just to make it a little bit more fuller, add a little bit more definition. Or what another thing I like to do is like put like a part, almost a section on the side here, and then I'll comb these down, this my front down to the side, and then I'll kind of play with the back a little bit. Not too much, because I know that the back didn't have a lot of curls. Most of the definition was in the front. So this is another look that I like to do for this particular wig. Or if it's like hell hot in St. Louis like it's been, I would simply tuck it behind my ears, kind of comb a little bit down to the side, put a little bit more in my bangs, and then I'll just kind of play around with the top, just again, just to give it a little bit of definition, and bam, she is ready. Okay guys, stay tuned for my second look. The second wig that I am going to debut is a much different look, but you guys would be totally in awe with this wig. I love this wig. Give me one moment, let me do the change. So I am back with my my second wig. This wig is like a bob, and it has a little bit of like almost like an asymmetrical cut going on. So it's not so much blunt, even cut at the bottom. It's a little bit layered going through the body of the wig. And then my favorite part is the bang. Now, if you guys notice, I don't do too many long wigs, only because of my face shape, I always feel like the short ones give me more of a flattering definition. So this particular wig here is not 100% human hair. It is a synthetic blend of human hair and synthetic. So it's just a mixture. It's made by It's Tress, and it is this particular season's collection. It's light, bouncy. This one is a lot lighter than the other one with the soft curls, but this one definitely is another fave. I definitely like to interchange between the two, so I'm gonna go ahead and install it for you guys. We're not really install it, but put it on. So I'm just gonna straighten it out, okay, and then hold on, I'm gonna do a little bit of brushing. Oh man, look at that. So I'm just brushing it just a little bit. Look at that. Look at you, girl. So I definitely love this wig. Now, it's not like a favorite of mine. And the only reason being is I think I needed it a little bit longer. It does show off my round face, my round fat face a lot. But I definitely like it for the bang. Now, I'm not good at just wearing my bang straight. So I kind of like them just a little bit slightly to the side. Just a little bit. Just so you can kind of see your girl face or whatever. But what you guys think? Both the wigs, and hold on, let me show you the back as well. And I'm sorry, I'm just pulling down the rest of them, the rest of my hair in the back. So both of the wigs are very, very comfortable. So that's how the back looks. They are very, very comfortable, very lightweight, very airy. I wear a wig cap under. It's not like your girl was bald head or anything like that, because I got plenty of hair. I just kind of like wearing wigs only because of the different looks that you can create. You can be simple and sassy. You can be hot and flirtatious. So this is the finished look of the flat one. I had a little bit of height up here that I needed to adjust, so I got it adjust. But yeah, this is, you know, how I look with the flat one. Now I could keep the bangs in front and then kind of tussle to bring this out just a little bit, just to give it a little bit of body. So this is how it would look if I wanted to not have it so flat, but just kind of play with it just a little bit, just to give it a little bit of, you know, just a little bit of definition. Just not too much, but just enough. Because ideally, as it gets older, it could, you know, like, you know, fill out a little bit more. But this is how she looks. This is definitely how she looks. So again, it's not my favorite. I kind of like mine with just a little bit of curls. I do wear, you know, my wigs, you know, rather flat as well. But yeah, I kind of like it. You know, I just have to kind of fix the top, play around with it a little bit. But definitely, you guys, this wig I've been wearing for a little over a month now. And then this one I haven't wore yet, just to get some feedback on what other people think. I am going to wear it this week. But for now, you guys tell me what you think. Which was your favorite? This, the straight bob, or the curly natural hair? Tell me in the comments which one was your favorite, which was a must-have look. Both of these wigs were under $40. I got them specifically for Black women, so I wanted it to be tailored to what me as a woman of color will wear. But I definitely think they hit their mark. Stay tuned for the next video when I debut 3 more wigs, or is it 4? Maybe 3. Maybe 4. Anyhow, guys, I will definitely see you in my next wig review. I hope you thoroughly enjoyed this video. If not, let your girl know so she can kind of make some. So if you made it this far and you like what you've seen as far as like the wig review, go ahead and just subscribe to your girl channel. Leave me a comment, why don't you? Or you can hit the thumbs up button so you can kind of see any other new stuff coming from me. I would definitely love to hear from you. Bye, guys.